Well, I think that the
motivation.
They are other people have made this point, so I don't want to pass it off as original. They're as scared as they are angry about their future, about their children's future, and about the loss of jobs in this country. I mean, the unemployment rate is so high that it touches almost every American outside of elite circles, and I think that's a fear that is animating a lot of this. There's no question in my mind that the leadership of the Republican Party is not just troubled by probably losing the seat in Delaware, but there's a sense, you talk to Republican strategists, that they now have an unpredictable force on their hands. They think it's enough to drive them to victory in November, and I think at this point they're right. But beyond that, in governing and in the next election, it is an unpredictable force. You look at everything they tried to do to save Mike Castle, the establishment candidate in Delaware, the state party, the national party, various endorsers, the governor of New Jersey, all coming in to try to stop Donald from winning, and they couldn't. And I think just from a cultural point of view, there are elite Republicans who are just as derisive in their characterization of the Tea Party and some of the candidates and of their motivations as, you know, a blogger on the Huffington Post would be.
What is it that scares people, Republicans, about O'Donnell, the winning nominee?
Delaware is a pretty blue state. Mike Castle was thought at the beginning of this campaign to be the only Republican in all likelihood that could win the state. The state wasn't always this Democratic. We elected people like Pete DuPont and Bill Roth, but that's 20, 30 or more years ago. And now we've got a very conservative candidate and a candidate who has been, you know, vilified by her own party in the course of this campaign. I don't know if she could have won in any event, Charlie, but certainly she's been harmed by the way that the Republicans in Delaware campaigned against her at the end. They created every 30-second spot that the Democrat will need to run against her in the course of this campaign.
What does this say, Mark, about Sarah Palin?
Well, I've said for a while I thought she was the most powerful person in the Republican Party. She's not picked winners in every race by any means, but she did pick a winning candidate, the more moderate candidate in New Hampshire, the former attorney general there who won her primary yesterday. And she did, along with Senator DeMint from South Carolina, come in to Delaware as the only prominent national figure to endorse. She's got really good instincts, and not just for who to pick, although not in every case, but also about how to describe what's going on. And the thing that I continue to be waiting for is to see, and it will happen if she runs for president, does anyone in the Republican Party ever stand up to her? You've heard grumbling about Senator DeMint and his endorsement in this case to help O'Donnell win. I've not heard anybody criticize Sarah Palin for her endorsement. And again, I'm waiting for that day, both as a spectator sport and to see how Sarah Palin reacts, because her power has continued to grow. She's not really diminished in any way. And usually in politics, if nobody reaches out to try to stop you from growing, you keep growing.
Join us online at charlierose.com.